Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a BBA101 Genius block. I have part number here IC660BBA101. In order to test this, we're going to test all the functions and features of the block. This is a resistance thermal detector, has six inputs, analog reading, and we're going to test the physical monitor port. That's for the IC660HHM501 monitor to be able to communicate with the Genius block. The serial port so that the Genius block can communicate with the bus controller, which is connected to the central processor and your software. Proficy Machine Edition is what I'm using for this test. And of course, all the inputs. So we'll start with configuring the block. Again, this is the handheld monitor, HHM501. And the first thing I'm going to check is that, for my purpose, I use the factory settings on the block, the factory settings and scalings for the block. So for those of you out there, I wouldn't recommend changing any of your settings if this is a working block. This is just what I do for a test. So I'm going to click OK because I know it's communicating at 153.6K standard baud rate. Go to configuration, F3. Program block ID, F1. And what I'm doing here is I've selected a block number that is the same as the block number that I've configured in Proficy Machine Edition. And the reason I do that is because when I get the software and CPU end of things in run mode, it's able to turn on my I/O enabled light. And that tells me now that this Genius block is communicating or talking with the bus controller and also the CPU through the serial port. So that's, now I'm testing the serial port to make sure that that's working, and it is. So we know that the monitor is working because I've been able to program it. So the next thing I want to do is check my configuration. So that's F3, F2. I do want to report faults, yes, for my purpose. I do want all channels active. I'm going to be testing all channels, so I have them selected as yes. And the rest of these settings are the factory settings. Celsius, platinum linearization, 100 ohms. That's the resistor that I'm using. Is actually a 100 ohm resistor. This is just to test each channel, so that's okay. 400 millisecond input filter time. Configuration protection is disabled. If yours is enabled, if you have your configuration protect on, I would leave it on. Okay. Next thing I want to do is analyze the block. So F2 and then F1 to monitor the channels. You can only monitor two channels at a time, or two inputs at a time, if you will. Input 1, input 2. What I'm going to do is I'm going to probe each channel, and I'll let you know what terminals I'm using in order to get these figures. Now, all of the channels have been configured the same, so I'm expecting very, very close to the same result for each channel once they're probed with the two ends, these two leads off of my resistor. So, channel number 1. I'm probing terminals 9 and 10. I'm getting a reading of 14.6, so pretty close to 15. Channel number 2 is terminals 13 and 14, 14.9. Again, very close to 15. Next, we want to check channels 3 and 4, inputs 3 and 4. So I'm going to toggle over to 3 and 4, pressing F1, 3 and 4. All right, so we're going to go ahead and probe channel 3. I'm touching terminals 13 and 14. Again, same figure. It's good to see. 21 and 22 allows us to probe channel 4. Again, 15. And we're going to toggle over one more time so that we can read inputs 5 and 6, or channels 5 and 6. Okay. So next is channel 5. And I'm probing terminals 25 and 26. It's a little difficult to keep them in there, but as you can see, very close to 15 again. And channel 6. I'm probing terminals 29 and 30. 29 and 30. It's difficult to keep it on here, but they're all within the 15 degrees Celsius range, which is good that we see all the channels are the same. So, I also want to mention that connected to this serial port, of course, is a bus controller. That part number is IC660BEM331. It's connected to an IC693CHS397 5-slot rack using a IC693PWR330 power supply and an IC693CPU374 for this test is what we're using. And that's also in Proficy Machine Edition. Now, if you have any problems with your Genius Block, if you power it up and you don't have lights that come on, or another thing that we typically see is if you go to the Configure ID screen on your handheld monitor, that's the IC660HHM501, and instead of getting a block number, you get a question mark where it is unable to store a configuration. These are common problems that we see with Genius Blocks, and it's something that we repair. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products with same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.